we decided to call it quits. So she just decided that she wasn't in love with me anymore. And in that way, we're still best friends. We still get along great. We just kind of grew apart, you know. I mean, she loved the big old fat Big Vinny. You know, she loved that guy, and that's who she fell in love with.
It's got to be tough, though. I mean, that's a big change.
There's definitely a lot of tough things about it. I mean, you know, her son, who's my stepson, who I love as my own, you know, he was my best friend, you know, and he's my little buddy, and he's 13 now, and, you know, it's definitely, that's the biggest part for me, is not being able to get to see him every day and hang out with him, which it's a mutual thing. We both decided that it's better for us. You know, I want to have kids. She doesn't want to have any more kids. So, you know, it's kind of, you know, figuring out life as a whole, you know, again. So.
And I think it's pretty strong to be able to admit that to someone.
Absolutely.
I mean, yep. that has to be hard.
No, you know what? I admire her a lot for saying it while I'm 31, as opposed to, you know, trying to make it work for 5 more years. If she knows, ultimately, deep down, that it's not what she wants, and I do want that. You know, I do want kids and all that, and if she's not attracted to me in that way, I would much rather say it now.
We wish you all the best, and, you know.
Yeah, no, absolutely, and like I said, you know, we're, you know, it's going to be a learning experience and all that kind of stuff, but in the meantime, I'm going to go out and date and have some fun and all that kind of stuff and just see what happens. You know, I mean, for me, I got to find somebody that wants to work out with me, that wants to do, not necessarily bodybuilding, but at least be in the gym, you know, 5-6 days a week.
Same interests.
And eat the same foods.
Do you remember how to date? It's been a while.
I know. I don't really know how. But
I don't think it's any problem. The girls seem to gravitate towards you.
I've always been a good flirt, no matter what.
And I remember you wrote that song, Love Me First. So now that you love yourself, I think it's going to be easier to find someone that you can, you know, blend with.
My biggest thing with that is, like, I always thought I was the hottest guy in the world whenever I was fat.
I
walked around.
You thought you were all that in a bag of chips.
I'd be like, listen, if Brad Pitt walks in here, tell him to get behind me. He's number two. But really, I was just doing that because if he got behind me, you couldn't see him anyway. So it actually worked out. But no, I always had that attitude and never was cocky or rude about it or ever put anybody else down. It's just like, I knew what I was worth as a human being. And that's what Love Me First is all about. It's all about knowing what you're worth.
If I'm ever gonna fly, if I'm gotta love me first.
And if you want to change something, then you have to believe you're worth that change.
I got a story if you got a minute. But don't worry, it's got a happy ending.